Yeah, first of all, I hope everybody knows where Barrio is. That is to begin with, it was only a small village in the interior of Sarawak, very close to the Indonesian border. But now, after the government resettlement in the 60s, that is a small township in itself now. So when you talk about, or when you want to know how's the homestay in Barrio, I come from that original village, the Barrio Asal, or original Barrio Longhouse. So the homestays in Barrio Asal are operated in the longhouse. You can stay with the families of the people from the longhouse, or you can stay with some other people whose houses are separate from the main longhouse structure. And what you can do is, if you like, you can spend your time leisurely according to what your host family might be doing for the day or for the next few days that you will be staying with them. For example, quite a few of them have pineapple orchards, and Barrio is also quite famous for its pineapple. In fact, Barrio is famous for its rice, and pineapple would be second in line, I think, because the pineapples in Barrio are very juicy and sweet. So quite a lot of people in Barrio plant pineapples. So when the need come, you want to spend your time there like a local, you can go and follow the orchard owner to clean his pineapple orchard, because that is very, very important to deter or to frighten away the pests like squirrels, which like to attack the pineapple fruits before they are harvested. The other things that you might want to do, of course, other than that, in general, we have trekking, mountaineering. But if you want to really experience the life with the family, that's why I told you that you can go and clean the pineapple orchard. Other things that you can do, maybe you can help with the fencing of the paddy field. If your host should require fencing, that is, you go and collect some jungle saplings or timber, plant the saplings as fencing post, and then you just help him to pull the barbed wire, because we use a lot of barbed wire, like to prevent loose buffaloes, I mean buffaloes which run around without being attended by the owners. Those can cause damages to the crops, like not only rice, but also crops like pineapples. They like to eat pineapple leaves, no? These are buffaloes. So that's why fencing is very important around the paddy field. So what else can you do? If you are a girl, maybe you can follow the female member of the host family to do whatever girls are doing, local girls are doing. Unfortunately, most of these things that local girls used to do have been taken over by modern systems like rice pounding. We don't send the rice to be pounded with the old traditional equipments anymore. But they are sent to the mill, where the mill is powered by a generator. But I'm sure there are some things other than that that girls do that you can actually do. Oh yeah, of course, one of the main things which doesn't change, and I'm sure will never change, is if you want wild vegetables. So this is where girls are good at. They go and collect wild vegetables for the family.